Today, Fahrenheit services cover the entire life cycle of a business. For new ventures and mid-sized companies, they continue to offer part-time backup CFO. When a business reaches a point, they need to hire a CFO or add other executives. Fahrenheit's recruiting team searches the entire country for the best candidate. If your company reaches a point and considers a sale, Fahrenheit offers investment banking services to manage the process of sale. Under Rich's leadership, a two-man shop is home to 80 employees in offices in Virginia, North Carolina, and Arizona. Virginia Business Magazine has repeatedly named Fahrenheit to its prestigious best places to work list. And a few weeks ago, the Chamber RBA recognized Fahrenheit's contributions to our local economy with this coveted impact. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming one of VCU's most connected graduates, a man who has made countless impacts on candidates, professionals, and thousands of companies, Rich Reinecke.
Happy birthday. this class, the winter ceremony, because I think that you and I have some things in common. If you're wearing a cap and gown today, it may be safe to guess that, like me, your journey through college may have been a bit unconventional. And I'm convinced that folks that are unconventional, folks like you and me, are inherently more prepared for success in business. And I think that it's this thing, being unconventional, is the reason I'm speaking to you today. My wife went to Virginia Tech, and she had this incredible experience, a very traditional experience. She lived on campus, and she graduated in 4 years. She loved every minute of it. It just wasn't my experience. I wore my class ring today, and if you look close, you'll notice it's engraved 1995, very fond year. Unfortunately, it was not the year that I actually graduated. I didn't graduate until 1996. Why? There's just a bunch of reasons. I grew up in a single-parent household, a very hard-working household, and although there was a really strong desire, one, for me to go to college, and two, to participate and pay for that experience, it just wasn't in the cards for me. So, like many of you, I had to work my way through school, and I know I'm not alone, right? Several of you here might have worked your way through school. I congratulate you on that. So when I was 13, I got my first job. I was the gate guard at a neighborhood pool. Imagine, very intimidating 13-year-old. I then worked retail jobs. I worked in restaurants. I worked in the kitchen. I waited tables with a bartender. And I also got married when I was in college. And I know I'm not alone there either. I imagine that there's a few of you that are married today as well. I knew that on my very first date with Heather, that was the woman I would marry. In fact, I left that date and went back to my apartment in the van and told my Delta Phi fraternity brother that night. I said, I'm going to marry that one. Like, don't fear failure, right? 22 years, we just celebrated our anniversary in October. I also recognize that if I wanted a shot at that girl, that I was going to have to show for her and probably more importantly, her parents, I was going up her trajectory. And so when I went and asked my father-in-law to marry his daughter, he said, you know, I really want to make sure you're going to graduate college. And I assume he probably also wanted some insurance that I was employable after college. So while I was still in school, I found some work that is going to put me really more in a position for success for what I'm going to do next. So I made a leap to pull my job at a company called Crestar Bank. You know that the Sunbelt Bank. My job at the time was to call people who had failed to qualify for a loan and tell them they didn't want it. This was a character building job. Not fun, because I did it full time. I switched things up. I went to school full time at night. And like you, I ultimately graduated. I missed the deadline that I had put in place with my father-in-law, but he understood that I was working hard. At the end of the day, it really didn't matter the year that was on my name. What mattered was I crossed the line. I took an unconventional route. I rolled with things. I found my way. I venture to guess that, like some of you here today, you're the same way. Maybe you took extra credits and graduated early. Or maybe your family and personal circumstances meant that you needed some time off. Or maybe you were working with one of them at the same time. This just happened to be the semester that you crossed the
innovation center.
Regardless, you had opportunities or you had obstacles. But the decisions you made brought you here to graduation today and the completion of this goal. And I believe that you'll have an advantage over other graduates and the workforce because you're able to roll with the business and you've taken that unconventional route. So don't ever forget that particular lesson. And the other two lessons here is never be afraid of failure if always act in the best interest of others. Early in my career, I've been fortunate of having a mother-in-law who was really involved in the business community. And as a result of that, even before I graduated, I was involved in networking and business opportunities way before I should have been. And today, I think most people will think that I'm an extrovert, but I think that most of that's a learned trait for myself. Today, people know me as a career vision. As a networker, a relationship developer, something they can work a room. And, but back then, when I was still finishing up my degree, right after graduation, I was absolutely terrified of that. And it seemed like everybody in those rooms was, you know, they had more education than I did at the time, and they were more experienced, they were older, they were more accomplished. I did several things. I forced myself into the center of those rooms. I focused on several things. Simply being kind, saying hello and making friends, getting people talking and finding those things that I could do for them. And it's interesting. If you focus your efforts on being kind and finding the impact that you can have on others, the university just has a way of taking care of you. Because I developed a network and a reputation, I had the opportunity at a very young age to go to work for a large national recruiting firm. I quickly differentiated myself from the norm in the industry, becoming known as a high integrity person, somebody who's truly looking out for my client's best interest, even when it was not in my best interest. I happened to be in the right place at the right time, in the right market. I had some success soon at local entrepreneur, approaching about becoming a partner and launching a new division of this same search firm in a division of this company. The inner voice always told me, I'll one day be an entrepreneur. So of course I did what any of you could. I quit my job. I jumped headfirst into this new opportunity. Instead of fear and failure, I took that leap of faith. I had not been paid for a while. I had to sit out for a year. But during that year, I worked at other parts of this business, and I built this business plan to launch this new venture. And things were going absolutely wonderfully. Got even better when one day my wife came running down our driveway with a fistful of balloons. And she said, we're pregnant. Quickly followed by the twins. I was on top of it. But then, to my surprise, this entrepreneur got an offer to sell his business back to corporate. And I'll never forget the afternoon when he too took a stroll down my driveway. This time, he changed my world in a very different way. He said, I got good news and I got bad news. And he said, good news, I'm rich. Bad news, you're not. And we can't continue on this path of building this business together. And I'm done. And it was traumatic. I had just walked away from a great job with a big firm. I was making what I thought at my age was way more money than I should have. And suddenly, I was out of work. My wife was pregnant with twins. And I was certain I would never replace the situation I had just left. I was trying to figure out how to pick up the pieces, and I remember the words of a mentor that met with me that day, and he said this, and I have returned to this many, many times as early as yesterday. He said to me, trust me, in the long run, you're gonna look at this tragedy, this thing that is so impactful to you today, and it's gonna be a blip on the radar. And I'd say, absolutely right. Tragedies today are absolutely clips on the radar. Losing that opportunity to be a partner in that business looking on a path where I am at today. And in short order, I went to the company that bought that business and I presented the opportunity that they've been planning for. And although I couldn't be a partner, I was able to convince them to launch this office here in Richmond with me at the helm. And essentially, I ran a multi-million dollar business. I just ran it with their checkbook. It's not a bad way for my business, by the way. In fact, it was that opportunity that gave me the confidence to launch my own business. And that's exactly what I did next. And over the course of 8 years, I built a great business. I hired employees. I had several different offices. They got bigger. Things expanded over a number of years. And then in 2008, something happened, a great recession. And I was in the business getting people jobs at a time when companies had stopped hiring. This is the school of business, and I know that all of you here realize that that is a bad recipe for success. So I found myself, after 8 years of really hard work, to watch all of this wash away fairly quickly. Through all of this, I tried to always be kind and treat people well, and most of all, I valued integrity. And although I was feeling desperate, held on the faith that something new would come with all my hard work. And I'm certain that that is exactly what prompted a call in 2009 from one of Richmond's greatest entrepreneurs, named Karen Evans. I knew Karen's reputation, and when she called me and said, hey, you want to grab lunch? I jumped at the chance. I had no idea where this would lead to go, but after we sat down for a few minutes, we realized we had the same values and we were going to launch a business together. By some miracle, young, inexperienced, incapable. I can tell you this because I'm all in. So when you leave here today, led by example, in your guide, and remember a couple of things here that we've talked about. You've already demonstrated yourself to be unconventional. Embrace that. Do not be afraid to fail. Understand that fear is going to be ever present, but really it's you that has the opportunity to decide whether to get wins or fail. And sometimes even when you're pursuing your dream, if it's just not happening for you, it's just not yet your time. Keep going. Opportunities are often disguised as failure. And third, always remember the goal. The sooner you genuinely get excited for everyone else's success around you, the sooner success will come to you. So, class of 2017, you've accomplished so much. Today is just the beginning. Congratulations.